Now, in this lecture, we will try to find out how the parsing is done for the input string. Let's say the input string here we have is AA, BB, and dollar. So now this is the string and we have to parse this string. We will use the parser, the LR0 parser. For doing the LR0 parser, we are making a table, item, the stack in which the symbols will be there, and the action we are going to take. Fine. So this is the string in which the first symbol is capital, small a. So the item is a small a and we are at the zero state. Okay, we will always be at the zero state as we have seen in the parsing table. The zero state is the first state that we are starting with. Fine. So we have a zero on the stack. The item is A. So in the zero state on A symbol, what action is to be taken? Zero on A, shift has to be done on the stack, and the rule by which we are shifting is 3. So A symbol has been pushed on the stack, and the rule by which we are doing it is the 3. So we are shift 3. So this is the action. Okay. So the next symbol we have is small a. Okay, so we are going to see 3 with a. So 3 with a, again this is suggesting us to shift. So 0a3 was already there on the stack. We have pushed a also, and the rule by which we are pushing it is 3. So again we have applied the rule is shift 3 or S3. Okay, now the next symbol we have is small b. So 3 on a small b, 3 on a small b, S4 means we have to shift this 4, shift this b on the stack. So 0a3a3 and then b4. We have shifted the symbol b on the stack. Then we will see another symbol, which is small b. So small b is there, 4 on b, stack state number 4 on b, state number 4 on b is suggesting us to reduce by the production number 3. So what is the production number 3? If you remember what was the production number 3, we will write those productions again here. First production was S produces capital A. A produces small a, capital A, and A produces small b. So these are the production rules. This is the first production rule, this is the second production rule, and this is the third production rule. So 4b, 4b is suggesting us R3. R3 means reduce by production number 3. So production number 3 is A produces small b. So we will reduce small b symbol with the left hand side of the production. But now remember, whenever we are going to reduce, we will be using double the number of symbols we have to replace. That means on the right hand side we have one symbol here in this production, we will replace two symbols from the stack to this capital A. Okay, so we are taking this one B4, two symbols. So these two symbols will be converted to capital A, that means the left hand side of the production. Rest of the symbols will remain same. Only we are changing these two symbols to the left hand side of the production. Okay. Now this actually is A, capital A. Now we have not written any number after this. So you will see 3A here. So 3 on capital A is suggesting us to go to 6. So we will write a 6 here also. Okay. Now see, for this symbol we have pushed on the stack, for this symbol we have pushed on the stack, this symbol also we have pushed on the stack. But when this symbol came, we have not pushed that on the stack. In fact, we have reduced some of the symbol on the stack to the left hand side of the production. So this symbol is already live. So what we have to decide now, that what action is actually required to be taken? 6B. Okay, now we have to take the action according to 6 and b. So what action will be taken on 6b? See, 6 small b, we have to reduce by production number 2. So the production number 2 is a produces, capital A produces small a capital A. So we have to replace this small a capital A with the left hand side of the production. Now since we have two symbols on the right hand side in this production rule, so we will replace 4 items from the stack. It means these 4 items with the left hand side of the production, that is capital A. So all these 4 symbols will be converted to capital A. Rest of the symbols in the stack will remain same. Okay, so what rule we followed? It is R2. Now we have 3 capital A. So 3 capital A is suggesting us to go to 6. So we will write 6 here. Now again, this B symbol is live. We have not converted this B symbol to any other symbol. We have not shifted the symbol on the stack yet. So this is live. So 6B, what action we are going to take by 6B? So 6B, 6th row, B column, R2. It means we have to replace, or we have to reduce by production rule 2nd. Production rule 2nd is A produces small a capital A. So 4 symbols, it has 2 symbols on the right hand side, 4 symbols from the stack. That means these 4 symbols will be converted to the left hand side of the production, that is capital A. So we have 0 capital A. Now 0 capital A is suggesting us to go to 2. Now once again this P is live. So 2 on B, state number 2 on B is suggesting us to shift the symbol on the stack. Okay, so 0 A 2 was already there. We have to shift this P now. So the rule that we have applied is shift 4. So we have applied a rule 4. Okay, now we have seen this symbol also, we have pushed that on the stack. The next symbol that we have on the in the input string is dollar. So 4 on dollar, 4 on dollar is suggesting us to R3. R3 means we have to replace according to, we have to reduce according to the production rule 3, which is suggesting us to convert B to capital A. So two symbols at the top of the stack will be replaced by capital A. Rest of the symbol on the stack will be same. So now 2 on capital A, 2 on capital A is suggesting us 5. Okay, the rule that we applied was R3. Fine, so dollar symbol is still active. Dollar symbol is still active. We have not done anything with the dollar. So 5 and dollar. 5 and dollar is suggesting us to replace or reduce by production number R1. So 5 on dollar, action is R1. R1 means reduce by the production rule number 1. Production rule number 1 is this one. S produces capital A, capital A. There are 2 symbols on the right hand side. So 4 symbols from the top of the stack will be replaced by the left hand side of the production, that is capital S. So we have 0 and capital S. Okay, now 0 and capital S. 0 and capital S suggesting us 1. Now 1 and dollar. At the next time, we have 1 and dollar. What action is actually required to be taken on 1 and dollar? So 1 and dollar we have to accept. So what does acceptance means? One, you can once again see this. 1 and dollar. 1 row, dollar column, accept. Accept means the string which was given to us, small a, small a, small b, small b, this string is according to the grammar rule. These are the grammar rules given, and the string which is we have formed, small a, small a, small b, it is actually according to the grammar rules. So we have successfully passed this string, and successful parsing of the string with the LR0 parser means that a string that we have taken is correct according to the grammar rule. Thank you.